This video I want to show the inner workings of a moving head fixture. These are the lights that move around and can shine their beams and shapes around stages and venues. This particular fixture is a Chevet Maverick Hybrid, which is one of the more complex moving head fixtures that we use at SXS, and it's got a lot of stuff going on inside it. So starting at the light source at the back, we've got an arc lamp source. The way that works is it strikes a little lightning bolt between two points inside its glass capsule, and there's an arc zapping away there the whole time in much the same way as how lightning works or how an arc welder works. That's a light source there. It then goes through a series of different optical elements. So there'll be some lenses in there that focus the light to get it more of a parallel beam, different lenses that make the light go out and change the angle at which they project. You've also got color wheels. So there's three color wheels, cyan, yellow, magenta, and on that wheel it fades from a very light bit of that color to very dark, and the wheel physically spins in front of the light path to add more or less of the color. In addition to that, you've actually got color wheels, which are a simple filter. It's called a dichroic piece of glass, which basically if you look at it, you see the color which it reflects back and some light can pass through. That's a series of fixed colors and they can drop in front of the light path as well. So you've got cyan, yellow, magenta, then a color wheel, and you also have a thing called a CTO wheel. This changes the color temperature of the light. Color temperature is basically how cold and blue it is or how warm and orange it is. If you look at different light sources in your house, you'll see that some are very warm, as we call it, and which means more yellow, and some are very cold, which is more blue. They're all white, just kind of more cold and warm versions of white. We've also got gobos in here. Now there's two types of gobos, there's metal and there's glass. So a metal gobo is a really, really thin, highly heat resistant piece of metal, which has got holes cut in it, or shapes, and that allows the light to pass through and project those shapes out into the room. Sometimes they might be like a logo or an image, other times they're just a series of dots or a bar, depending on what they're used for. You've also got glass gobos. What they are is a piece of glass with a mirrored surface to it, which is laser etched through. Wherever the laser etching is, light can pass through and that shape projects out of the light. So they tend to be used for much more complex and detailed images, maybe like logos or text or when you've got multiple colors going on. So metal and glass gobos. Then you've got the lens arrangement, and this is where the technology's really moved forward in the last few years. We've now got a whole range of lenses which allows to focus, that means make it more or less blurry or really sharp if that's what you want, and also zoom lenses, which mean the beam can be very, very narrow or very wide. What makes this particular fixture unusual though is that it's a hybrid. It has an additional lens assembly that actually physically drops into the light path and it changes it from being a spot which projects gobos to a certain zoom range, a beam which is a very, very narrow, almost laser-like beam of light coming out, and also wash mode which is very, very wide and a much softer light source. So that's the absolute basics of the inside of a moving light. There's a lot more to know, but hopefully that gives a bit of an idea of what these things are like and why we spend so much time maintaining these things and why they can do so much cool stuff on events. Again, Chevet Maverick Hybrid.